കേരളത്തിൽ ദൗത്യസംഘം ഉൾപ്പെടെ രൂപീകരിച്ച ആളുകൾക്കെതിരെ നടക്കുന്ന അക്രമം തടയണമെന്ന് മേനകാ ഗാന്ധി പറയുന്നു. മലപ്പുറം എന്ന് താൻ പറഞ്ഞത് വനംവകുപ്പിൽ നിന്ന് ലഭിച്ച വിവരങ്ങളുടെ അടിസ്ഥാനത്തിലാണെന്നും പിന്നീട് മേനകാ ഗാന്ധി ഏഷ്യാനെറ്റ് ന്യൂസിനോട് വിശദീകരിച്ചു. ഞങ്ങളുടെ പ്രതിനിധി പ്രശാന്ത് രഘുവംശം മേനകാ ഗാന്ധിയുമായി സംസാരിച്ചു. അതിലേക്ക്
കേരളത്തിൽ ആനചരിഞ്ഞ സംഭവത്തെക്കുറിച്ച് പ്രതികരിക്കാൻ എം പി ശ്രീമതി മേനകാ ഗാന്ധി നമ്മളോടൊപ്പം ചേരുകയാണ്. ശ്രീമതി മേനകാ ഗാന്ധി, യെസ്റ്റർഡേ യു കെയിം ഔട്ട് സ്ട്രോങ്ലി അഗൈൻസ്റ്റ് ദാറ്റ് ഇൻസിഡന്റ് ഇൻ കേരള. ഹൗ ആർ യു ഫോളോയിങ് അപ് ദിസ് ഇഷ്യൂ?
No, we are following it up by talking to the center and the state. The point is that we can only talk if somebody is listening. The whole of it's not just me, it's the whole of India is talking. There must be at least 1 lakh letters and emails that have gone to your state. The point is that is your Asha Thomas going to listen? Is Mr. Raju going to listen? Is the CM going to listen? Is Surendran going to listen? The question is not of talking but of listening.
You said almost 600 elephants died in Kerala yesterday.
No.
So from where do you get that?
These are your own figures. Your own figures say 600 elephants a year are killed in Kerala.
Also, you said that the incident happened in Malappuram, but actually it happened in Palakkad. There has been reaction also that it didn't happen in Malappuram.
Happened in Malappuram. That is the communication that was given to us by the Forest Department. The FIR is also in M. Malappuram. So how can you say it happened in Palakkad?
No, it happened in the Mannarkad division in Kerala. Mannarkad division belongs to Palakkad.
Department.
And the FIR is also registered there. I think the first report came from Malappuram, Dateline Malappuram.
No, and also the Forest Department, when we checked with them, they said it happened in Malappuram. But it is irrelevant where it happened. The point is that the whole of Kerala is now obsessed with the killing of elephants. And the government of Kerala takes absolutely no action. In no other state in India are they being killed the way they are being killed in Kerala. Now, one of the reasons for this bomb to be made, which means there's a bomb factory, right? Now, bomb factories are being run because this is a professional bomb. This is not patakas. This is a bomb in which pressure, when it is applied on, it bursts. Okay, it's a pressure bomb. Now, why was a bomb being made to begin with? That means there's a factory somewhere making bombs. Also, for the last 3 months, we have been speaking to the government of Kerala and telling them that you have declared a war on the wild boar. Now, wild boar is an extremely important animal for the forest. If you remove the wild boar, you will have total, you will have no forest left, in Kerala especially. And you will have a lot of other problems. Now, if you encourage people to make bombs and throw them in the forests and throw them on the farmers' lands, then wild boar will never die. But a lot of other animals will die from a pressure bomb. Now, the person who has done this to this elephant is obviously one of those people who were involved in the bomb making.
So did you speak to any Kerala official on this matter?
Yes, I've been speaking to your forest secretary, Asha Thomas. I spoke to Surendra. Nobody's interested.
Today, the minister, Mr. Javadekar, said that he will intervene in this issue.
What can he intervene? What can he intervene? Until Kerala, what will he intervene in? The question is not of one death, Beta. Kerala is such a wonderful country, okay? Why ruin it by being so vicious to animals? Now, these elephants are no longer even from Kerala. Most of these elephants have been smuggled from Bihar, from Assam, from Odisha, because you have killed most of your elephants. So the point is, why are you raping the whole of India in taking away the elephants? Elephants are really important for the forest regeneration. So, firstly, I have requested the government again and again and again to A, stop private ownership and temple ownership of elephants, because that is killing them. One dies, they get another one. Another dies, and almost every second day one elephant is dying. It is not just this elephant. You know perfectly well that 3 days ago, 4 days ago, one more elephant died of a bomb in Kollam. Now there is one more elephant in Trichur, which is near death, in that mandir, which Asha Thomas knows about. I forget what was the name of it, Kovil Manikyam. Kodal Manikyam. then there are so many elephants like this that I can give you a list of in Kerala, all of which die, but the government doesn't do anything. So one is, they should stop this war that they have declared on wild boar. Two, they should be very strict on finding the bum factories. Three, they should stop private ownership of elephants. After all, you cannot own a tiger. So how can you own an elephant? They are both Schedule 1. And there are less than 20,000 left. And there are only 800 tuskers. So how will you get any more? The species is unique to us. If we lose it, the world loses it. So these are the three things. Four is making of rescue centers. Those have to be made immediately. No, and fifth is make a task force. All the elephants that are unlicensed, there are about 290 elephants that are unlicensed. The Supreme Court has already ordered the Kerala government 2 years ago to pick them up. They have not been picked up. They have to be picked up immediately. And we'll have to find rescue centers for them. This is what I've asked the government to do.
Thank you very much. എന്തായാലും ഒരു ദൗത്യ സംഘം ഉൾപ്പെടെ രൂപീകരിച്ച് ഇത്തരം വിഷയങ്ങളിൽ ഇടപെടണം എന്നുള്ളൊരു ആവശ്യമാണ് ശ്രീമതി മേനകാ ഗാന്ധി ഉന്നയിക്കുന്നത്.